The use of cell lines has become an invaluable alternative to animal testing in recent years.
Research at Eawag, in the context of environmental toxicology, is leading the way.
A big topic in our research is to replace animal testing. We do this in environmental toxicology, so we focus on fish. We use cells derived from fish, which we can culture indefinitely. And this has allowed us to already propose a number of tests which can actually replace toxicity testing using fish.
However, one major challenge has remained: the reliance on fetal bovine serum to sustain fish cell cultures, at least until now.
Fetal bovine serum, it's very rich in growth factors and nutrients, but we really aim to replace this last animal-derived component.
The team led by Eawag researchers Barbara Josef and Christine Schirmer has now developed such an alternative. In cell culture research, fetal bovine serum is considered the most widely used animal-derived additive to medium. It is a nutrient-rich mixture that, as the name suggests, comes from the blood of fetal calves.
The serum is obtained in an inhumane process. It is therefore important for researchers to not use it, if possible. Various serum-free alternatives are on the market, but none of them works for fish cells.
Josef began her search for a suitable alternative by finding out what fish cells need to grow and laid the groundwork for initial tests. To speed up the analysis, Josef developed a new method to quantify cell proliferation. Once the Eawag researchers knew what the fish cells need, the next challenge was replacing FBS components with defined alternatives. The team carefully selected vitamins, minerals, hormones, growth factor, and lipids to recreate the necessary growth conditions, minimizing animal-derived components wherever possible. Once the new medium was decided on, the acid test followed. They accustomed the fish cells to the new medium by reducing the amount of FBS with each medium exchange until the cells could grow without it entirely. And it worked. Josef and her team also demonstrated that these cells can be frozen in liquid nitrogen and revived if needed, an important factor in cell research.
Our research should encourage other researchers to try and to adapt our process or medium for their own cell lines. This would be an important step forward towards animal-free research. I hope that the industry will offer soon more replacement options for animal-free components, because at the moment we can only test what the market is offering.
But the new medium, which now anyone can prepare in their lab, comes at a price. Compared to fetal bovine serum, alternatives are still expensive. But presumably, this will change too. Josef has high hopes for reduced prices with increasing demand.